Everybody's had bad flying experiences, but you have not had one like this. A man on a Southwest Airlines flight traveling from Seattle to Phoenix is facing federal charges now because while sitting next to other passengers, he pulled down his pants and masturbated for hours, taking breaks and then starting up again. It's a horrifying situation. His name is Antonio Sherrodd McGarity, seated in seat 11F. Female witness was seated in 11E. Shortly after taking off, the complaint says, and while the aircraft was in the air, McGarity exposed his penis by pulling down his pants and shorts and began masturbating. When the female seated next to him noticed the lewd behavior, she began taking pictures of McGarity. This is an amazing sentence. When he fell asleep after masturbating for roughly an hour, the female passenger told a crew member about what she'd witnessed and was allowed to move to another seat. That's the response the plane had. McGarity was arrested by officers once they landed. He told cops that he didn't do anything wrong and in fact, quote, thought it was kind of kinky. So look, we're gonna have more details on this. I am incredibly sympathetic about the position that the flight attendants are put in this situation, because as we continually talk about the horrendous treatment of flight attendants, the violence and harassment, they should never have to deal with anything like this. Also, passengers should never have to deal with anything like, no woman should have to deal with anything like this on a plane. All you want to do is get done with the flight and to be literally exposed to something this disgusting, Dan, I can't even imagine.
What kind of entitlement where the guy just goes, oh, I don't know what I was doing wrong. I thought it was kind of kinky. Like in any context, consent is needed from both sides. And by the way, public stuff, generally no. Like you're on a plane, you're gonna be exposed to like a bunch of different people. I mean, definitely not COVID safe to say the least. I also have a few like logistical issues with this. First of all, that's like Seattle to Phoenix is like a 2-hour flight, really, dude. Like there's so, you could definitely wait on that. Every aspect of that from top to bottom is, I mean, at least he probably waited until you could take the tray table position down because it's at a few minutes into the flight. But most of all, I can't believe, like us normal people can't put ourselves in the position of the kind of person who would do this behavior. But unfortunately, like you said, flight attendants have had to deal with people refusing to wear masks, getting drunk and disorderly on planes, right? Like, unfortunately, people just believe they can act whatever kind of way in public. And there needs to be, I think everything that was done is the best you could do at that point. Let's move you to another seat. If we de-board the plane or whatever, we delay it, it's going to cause a headache for everyone else. Let's arrest them immediately. And, you know, at bare minimum, it looks like they've received a lifetime ban.
Yeah, there was a lifetime ban. They did not get duct taped to the seat, which has happened in other cases and might have been warranted in this one. By the way, I won't identify, but a flight attendant in the chat says, I had this happen on one of my flights, except it was an elderly woman. So look, it happens. I will say, I don't know the individual. I am not a psychic. But some people are saying, why not just go in the bathroom? Because they didn't want to go in the bathroom. They wanted to do it there because this was not about the masturbation as much as about creating that situation for other people, inflicting it on them. This is a form of rape. And like most rape, it is about exercising disgusting, perverse power over unwilling people. And so he says that he asked the female witness if she minded if he masturbated. According to her, she put her hands in the air and said, it really doesn't matter. He thought the response was kind of kinky and believed the female was comfortable with him masturbating. So I don't believe anything that he says, but even if she was comfortable with it, you can't do it. There are other people around. And also, he is purposefully missing the fact that she is in a horrendous, unimaginable situation. Imagine even being asked a question like that and believing that, oh no, she consented to it, I guess. No, this is obviously insane. Intentionally, he's being charged for lewd, indecent, or obscene acts on an aircraft. And thankfully, these sorts of things are a little bit more rare than the violence, although definitely passengers and flight attendants have been sexually assaulted as well as harassed in the past. Just recently, on a Delta flight, a passenger mooned his fellow travelers during a mask meltdown. So yeah, be careful where you fly. Keep your stuff together because there's a lot of crazies out there and they might be on the plane with you.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.